our last review now is up. We are going to review the last episode of The Acolyte. And hopefully it's the last ever episode of The Acolyte.
I'm doubtful about that.
Really? Really? You think we'll get season two?
It's hard to say.
Yeah.
But yeah, there was a surprising amount of things that were brought up in this last episode that I was like, all right, well,
they definitely have a plan. Like,
yeah, you have some sort of a plan, and mm-hmm. you're introducing two really big components, one more so than the other. Like, mm-hmm. and I was like, I am interested, but I hate everything. I hate a lot of things. Not everything. Yeah. I hate a lot. I really dislike a lot of things that have been done so far. So, yeah. like, I'm not excited
For sure.
a season two, but it's like, it would also be, and not like, obviously, like, you know, if people don't like something, they're just going to have to cancel it. And maybe it'll just be like, well, that was it. And like, we can just infer what happens after that, after, you know,
right.
But it felt like there was some big ideas that were introduced in this last episode. Huge. That I was like, well,
yeah,
I mean, if you don't follow it up, that's like, that's a little frustrating. I guess so, like,
before we go, do you want to go through this episode kind of more chronologically, I guess?
Yeah, I mean, if you want to.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think it's good to keep track that way, right?
Okay.
But yeah, so we will definitely talk on those big ideas. But yeah, I will say, really interesting scene to start off with, where Osha's still in the mask and she like takes over like Khmer, but he has like the will and the strength to like take off the mask for her. I think it would have been nice to have seen this vision. But she thinks she sees a vision of May striking down Soul, but without a lightsaber. Which, I mean, unspoilers, but we know by the end of the episode that she saw herself doing that. But yeah, basically her and Khmer agree to go to Brendok together, because she won't tell him where he is and he won't let her take his ship. And I'm like, okay, all right, I guess we're doing this. But yeah, I don't know. To me, it felt like, well, he could easily have just read her mind, you know, like, and just taken the location from her, but
right.
whatever. We'll write it so that we can line up where we need to.
It was a kind of cool chase scene, I guess, a bit. Like, I like the VFX of them in that like asteroid belt sort of thing. Yes. That's what you're talking about.
No, well, so I was speaking more on Khmer and Osha having to travel together.
Okay.
But yeah, no, but I totally agree. Yeah, like May, I hated that even more, to be honest, where like May, you know, she wakes up and Sol's explaining everything to her. And before he can get like the last word out, he like stabs him with the electric thing. And I'm like, okay, I guess she's going to leave and we're going to chase and we're going to go to Brendok and all that. And so, yeah, no, the chase through the asteroid belt was cool. I don't really understand why Basil felt like he needed to sabotage Sol's ship.
I was wondering when that was gonna.
I guess Basil knows that Sol isn't like a totally good person. I guess I don't know. It was confusing, but it sends both of them crashing into Brendok, and yeah. So they all, you know, Osha and Khmer land on Brendok now. And while Sol is looking for May, he runs into Khmer, and they have a pretty good fight. I will say that.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
He has some good force powers that he uses. Sol is clearly an amazing fighter at this point, and he really does beat Khmer. But what again is so frustrating is that he had like he sliced the lightsaber and had the lightsaber at his neck, and just didn't go through with it. He didn't arrest him. He didn't kill him. He just didn't do anything. And I was like, what are we doing? Like, you're just letting this guy live for the stories, for story's sake. You're not making it plausible at all, you know? Yeah, so that was rough. But yeah, then we also get scenes back at on Coruscant where Venestra is speaking with the senator, and he's like, "Yeah, you know, the Jedi like are really."
Senator. I like that senator. Yeah, he was a good character.
Yeah, but he's you know really mistrusting of the Jedi, and probably for a good reason.
Yeah.
Yeah, she still doesn't tell him the entire truth, and so she goes and investigates with a huge team, and you know, basically her story through this episode is she knows that Sol didn't do this, but for the sake of the Jedi, she is willing to pin all of the crimes on him, which is really unfortunate. And she also
unfortunate. Yeah,
it's really disappointing. This is probably the better word. And I would say it's more disappointing because she even knows who did do it. Like she knows her apprentice was there and like probably killed Sol and has turned evil. Like she even says that he's turned evil. So she knows that Khmer is doing all of this. And
there's
that,
just so yeah. much like her character alone just makes me, and maybe this is what the show wanted me to think.
Yeah.
Like it makes me really not like the Jedi at all.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, she was genuinely like the antagonist in the Jedi this season. And I know like there were some people who weren't the happiest seeing like this character they had read about in the books turn to be like this kind of a person, you know? So I don't know. Maybe they will scale back some of the badness that Venestra has shown us this season.
She needs to get a new Padawan too.
They clearly Mog sucks. Yeah, I hate Mog. But she definitely they've set her up for a big arc next season. If they do a season two, because she is now partnered with May, and she's looking for Khmer, and
who seems to be an old Padawan.
Right. He's an old Padawan of hers that's turned bad, and she even brings this information at the very end of the episode to Yoda. So that's, I don't know if Yoda will be involved with that storyline next season.
That's what I was going to say. Like out of the two big things that were introduced,
right?
Maybe three, which is one, Venestra was the old like master of Khmer. Two, you bring in Yoda, which at that point, that could just be like a little cameo. It doesn't actually have to be like anything that like he's, you know, a big part of like the next season or whatnot.
Sure.
But the third thing is like the biggest
thing. We kind of missed it going through the story was that, as Osha and Khmer jet off from their planet, you get a glimpse of Darth Plagueis.
Which we should say is not confirmed that that's who that is. I think it's just everybody is very heavily.
I think it's like a 99% confirmation at this point. I feel like I've heard the showrunners maybe talk about it at this point as well.
I agree. Yeah. I think that's who it is.
Yeah, for sure.
But I was so frustrated when I saw that shit. I should have been excited. I really should have. But I was so frustrated.
Well, it's just because it's attached to this show now, you know?
It was attached to this show. And second, like, just like one third into the episode and we get like this creepy hand and the eyes and then that's it. And I'm like, what? Yeah. What? I don't know. I was just a little frustrated. It's like, could I maybe get that at the end?
Like, basically, to me, like, if you're a huge Star Wars fan, like it's even a little bit of a struggle to know like why he's there, you know, what was the purpose of that? And so like for casuals, they're just like, who the hell was that? You know? So I have a couple of theories there for why he's on that planet and stalking Khmer. And I guess it depends on something being canon. Basically, like I don't know if it's true, like if it's canon or not, but like I had read that the story of Plagueis is that like he had experimented with immortality, like trying to be immortal so much through his life that the Force as a response created like life somewhere else, and that being Anakin, right? And so like he's not responsible for making Anakin. And so if that's canon, that, and or if it's not canon, it kind of changes the theory where, like, so let's say that is canon. I think the reason he would be there at that point is because Khmer is possibly like his master's other apprentice. And after Plagueis killed his own master, he's, or maybe after Plagueis' master died, I don't remember if that's how he died or not. He is now going to go and kill Khmer so that he's the only Darth side user, or he's going there to either recruit Khmer as an apprentice or recruit Osho as an apprentice. But yeah, basically it's something along the lines of that, if that is canon. Now, if it isn't canon, the other theory is that he's the creator of Anakin, right? And that he's stalking them to learn the secrets of Osha and how she was created from the Force. And so
that's what I think it is.
Yeah. It's possible.
I think it's like, to be honest, like, I think I'd have to get like to learn exactly how it would be that he would create Anakin. But like what I'm gathering and what makes sense to me is like he would be very interested in. I don't know how he would know any of this.
Right. Hey, how would he know about Osha? I guess you're thinking at that point, like you're thinking he knew about this witch cult and maybe he helped in creating life there. I don't know.
It's
a big jump because they never even show him in the show, like with the witches. So,
like to me, like somehow he's aware that they are a part of like that convergence, which is a very powerful thing. And then obviously his whole thing is about like wanting to learn how to create life. And he like sought after it for a long time. And even like in episode 3, like Palpatine's like, it's not a story that the Jedi would have ever told you. And so like, I think like, obviously that ties in. It just makes me really frustrated that like the story of him is now potentially linked up to like this cult of witches, Nan Osha, Khmer, this whole story that's been extremely frustrating.
Agreed. Yeah, it's this really bad journey that's gotten us to a really interesting character. Been introduced badly in a sense.
And I fear that like if we do get a season 2, like this show's like it does look better than some Disney Plus like Star Wars shows, I think. But like I still don't think it's gonna look as cool or dramatic as like you would want for like especially introducing a character like that. Like I'm just nervous that he would be introduced as like a
I need the tone to be way, way more intense and darker than like the Acolyte has been.
Yeah.
For a Darth Plagueis to be like the main antagonist.
Yeah.
I guess back to this season. I think some really upsetting decisions they made was, I'll say after the upsetting decision of Sol not killing Khmer, Sol then is interrupted by May, and he explains finally to May that her and her sister aren't twins and that they're the same soul. I don't really know why that changes much, but in Sol's eyes it does, and Osho overhears it, and Sol's like, look, I did the right thing. I was trying to protect you, and I lied so that you could have the life that you wanted to live. And Osho in this episode snaps. And I'm not going to say it's a natural snapping, because it really feels like from episodes 1 to episode 7, do we ever see like Osha get angry? She got angry at Khmer.
She got angry at her sister multiple times, and like she even like the first time that she saw May, she like there was a second where they saw each other, and then she immediately like shot at her.
But that's not. I wouldn't say that's anger.
I don't know. To me, she looked pretty angry.
Yeah.
There is bits throughout the show that I was like, like she's got some anger in her.
Yeah, I think the only time though for me I could really tell was last episode or episode 6 when she like struck at Khmer almost and killed him. So I don't know. It feels very much like a Daenerys in season 8 of Game of Thrones.
There's a bit of that, but like it feels more natural to me than like May's big switch. You know what I mean?
And I think what is maybe frustrating for me too is that like Sol never says what I want him to say. You know, like he never is like, look, I acted in self-defense from your mother. You know, like to me, that is what truly happened. And he never says that. All he is just like, well, I killed her for the good of, you know, the universe. And, you know, she was too powerful. And like he had gone there to kill her. Like, I don't know it, which I don't think was ever the case, you know? So Osha full on blames Sol for killing her mother. And before he can say, I love you to Osha, she force chokes him and kills him. Which to me, I think is a huge mistake killing Sol. Like not even like for the character of Osha, but like for the story or for the livelihood of this show, you know? I think Sol was like the one person at this point that I was happy following, like their story. And now that he's gone, I don't care about Osha. I don't care about May. I don't care about Khmer. I don't care about Vernestra. So why would I want to watch next season? Like, I thought we were going to have him arrested and maybe have him like go through this arc of like, you know, being wrongfully accused and having to like fight in the courts of Coruscant and maybe getting free from that at some point next season. But nothing of that is going to happen because he's just dead. And we've lost a great actor in this series. So,
yeah, I mean, unless they're able to write May, Osha, Khmer into they really write them characters. Better.
Right.
And like, all right, let's just take Osha as like now a dark side user. And like Khmer is her master slash potential lover or whatever the fuck. I don't know.
I don't. Their relationship is so confusing, Zach. It's so confusing. Like, I guess I need to ask this. Why did Osha feel like she needed to make a deal with Khmer? Like, was Khmer like threatening them at the end? I didn't feel that way.
Well, I guess because he wanted to kill May still, but like her bargaining chip, I guess, in was like, well, you'll get an apprentice out of me if you spare my sister.
I guess maybe that's what I missed, because it just didn't feel like he was threatening May either at that point. But maybe he was, and I just missed it. But yeah, so she full on goes to be, you know, Khmer's acolyte. And they're seen holding hands at the end. And you're like, I thought this was just a deal. Like, are you guys like,
I don't know.
Are you guys closer than I thought you were? Or I don't know. It's just, and it's like, and like, why would she be holding hands with him when like earlier in the episode, she was so confident in her decision not to join him as his acolyte, you know? And I don't know. It just seems like such a weird 180 for the character just to get her to this point in the story.
But it's the same 180 that we saw, or even, 180 that we saw back in like episode 4, you know, where like both those characters, or at least May, just completely was like, no, this changes everything.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, May takes a complete 180 in episode 4 and then makes another 180 in episode 5 to go back to what she was. And I'm like, okay, sure. And then they also make, you know, May, because she forgot her memories up, you know, from the time she was 8 until present day, she's just going to be this innocent person helping the Jedi. But like, wouldn't she be an 8-year-old mentally at that point? Right?
Yeah. It's not exactly clear how much of her memory was wiped.
Well, I mean, even, it's like Vernestra, doesn't she say like, it seems like your memories, like from the time, you know, of that, Or I don't know. She says something to the effect like, your last memory was when your mother died, which was when she was like 8 years old.
Oh, well.
Yeah. When I'm just like, excuse me? That is a huge, like, the character is a completely different person at that point.
Right.
And yeah. So I don't know. It's an interesting choice. I don't love it. I don't love any of what we're set up with at the end of this episode.
Yeah. I mean, like you said, like there's not really any character that I particularly want to follow. The only thing that now I'm interested in is like, because if this,
Darth Plagueis for me, yeah, is the only thing.
Yeah. Exactly. And if they didn't have that, I'd be like, all right, just end the show. Like,
yeah,
just
yeah,
straight up
sure.
like, yeah, you got to have the Yoda cameo because we know that Yoda would have been around.
Right.
But it's like, okay, that's just, let's just end the show. Like we tried,
yeah.
But now it's like, you've opened that door and now you're going to have people that are like, I'm not saying that it means that a season two is going to happen, but it's like, you've put that idea out there. It doesn't have to happen. Cause you can just be like, well, this is some, maybe that's, you know, tied in to Plagueis and now like the water's muddier, but like,
right. Yeah. I don't
but
know.
Now you're going to have people like me that are like, well, now I want to know what your idea was. But at the same time, I'm like, maybe also don't touch
don't.
It. Just don't touch it anymore. And just like, all right, well, you tied it in and maybe we can come up with our own reasons as fans. But like,
I think leaving it up to our imagination will be better than anything they could come up with.
Probably.
I just have no faith in the writers over for Star Wars anymore. And maybe that's not something that I should feel, but like, for the most part, Star Wars shows have not been good as of late. And doesn't matter who they have lead them. It just, it's not turning out well. So yeah. It's a frustrating time, and to be a Star Wars fan, I'll say, and I don't know. I would like to see more of Plagueis, but not from these writers. So I don't know. It's rough. It's rough out here.
Yeah.